If you're used to working with Adobe Photoshop, then Illustrator should be pretty easy for you to adapt to. However, if you're new to Illustrator, it's a good idea to familiarize yourself with the workspace so you can work more efficiently. So let's go over the various parts of the workspace and how to customize it so that you can get started working in Illustrator. Before we start though, if you're on a Mac and you've opened Illustrator for the first time, it probably doesn't look like what you're seeing here. Illustrator on a Mac for some reason has a floating application, which means you can see the desktop and the icons on the desktop and everything's just kind of floating around. I find that pretty distracting, so I went up to the window menu and clicked application frame, and that allows me to see a normal application where I don't see anything underneath this gray area here. On a PC, you don't have to worry about this. So let's go ahead and get started talking about the various parts of the workspace. This white area here is called an artboard, and in this document, I actually have three different artboards. This is really great if I was designing a logo for a client and I had three different options, because then I get to keep those three different options separate, but also in one document, so it's easier to send to people. Outside of the artboards, we have this gray area, and this is considered the canvas. This is where you can store different items or text or pictures or whatnot that you might want to use later, but you don't actually want to appear on your artboards because you're not sure about them. On the left-hand side, you'll see the toolbar, and this has all of the tools that you're going to use in Adobe Illustrator. And again, if you've worked with Photoshop before, this should be fairly simple. But if you haven't, know that most of your tools, if you hover over them, it'll tell you what the name of the tool is. It also has a letter right next to the name of that tool, and when you hit that letter on your keyboard, it'll automatically switch that tool. Some tools, like the selection tool, are standalone tools. You just click it and you start using it. But there are other tools, like let's take the shape tool, and you can see a little arrow in the bottom right hand corner. This tells you that there are similar tools hidden underneath this one. So if I click and hold, it's going to bring up a little flyout menu that has all the various shapes that you can create in Illustrator. Sometimes this can get kind of tedious. Let's say I want to do a big project that has a lot of different geometric shapes. I don't want to have to keep coming to this and holding it down every time I want to create a new shape. So Illustrator has this option for you called a tear off tab that you can click, and it's going to tear that little flyout menu off so that you can quickly and easily access those tools. It doesn't mean they're gone, they're still there. It just kind of made a copy for you to easily use. So I'll go ahead and close that. Now with Illustrator, every time you click on a tool, just know that you might need to set some of the options up here for that tool. Unlike Photoshop, which the options change drastically for each tool, for the majority of the tools in Illustrator, all of these options stay the same. There are ones like the artboard that all of a sudden you'll see a bunch of different options, but most of them are going to use the basic set that we just saw. Now this application bar up here is unique to a Mac. You can launch Bridge and you can change the way documents are arranged. It's not actually unique, it's just that on a PC you'll see your menu bar and then you'll see the application bar, these specific buttons. On a Mac it's just one whole bar by itself. Then we have the regular menu bar, so anytime you're doing, let's say, a tutorial video online or you're in a class where they're using Adobe Illustrator, anytime they say menu, they want you to go up to the very top and choose one of these menus. And just realize that you have keyboard shortcuts next to some of these menu commands, and you're going to get real tired of sometimes of coming up and doing the same action, for instance, undo all the time. And this is where you want to use keyboard shortcuts to be more efficient. Last but not least are the panels, and these panels I can drag out so that they're separate panels, but as you can see, it's just like Photoshop or really any other Adobe program. A panel is indicated by a little tab, and you can see that some panels are active while some panels are hidden behind other panels, and you just have to click their name to make them active. Now, as with other Adobe programs, you can collapse or expand these panels, but with Illustrator, they actually have three different levels. So I can double click the word color and it's going to collapse that whole panel. I can double click again, or just actually one click, and it's going to do the full expanded version of that, and double click again and it's going to give me a halfway point and then collapse. That's also what this little button is on the left. You can do full, medium, small. So when it comes to your workspace, you're going to start finding that there are some panels you use a lot and there's some panels that you never use. And sometimes you get a workflow going and you like to have your panels in a certain spot. If that's true, then you can definitely customize your workspace. So if I grab this panel tab, I can move it over and I'll go ahead and group these together. And if I go up to the window menu, you can see that there are a ton of other panels that are currently not up in our document. Now, the ones with the check marks show that they're active, but just so you know, the brushes panel, it's not active, but it is actually showing up over here. So let's go ahead and choose, let's see, document info, because it doesn't look like we have that panel at all. So now we have these two panels that go together, document info and attributes. And this is what we can do. We can have a floating panel over here. We can grab this particular tab and use our drop zone. You can see a little blue bar, and this is going to create a second column. So I can move this one. So let's say it's down at the bottom. So it creates two of these and expand them. And you can kind of resize the different columns, and you can expand or collapse any of these and just move things around the way you need them to be. When you get all of your panels and everything situated the way you like it, you can go up to the window menu, go to workspace, and do new workspace. So I'll call this my name, because this is the settings or the workspace that I like to work with, and click OK. And now when I go to workspace, you'll see that I have this Jessica option. So if I ever mess up this option, let's say I want to move document info so it's a floating panel here, and let's say I accidentally get rid of the brushes panel, it's not going to permanently change that workspace. All I have to do is go to Window, Workspace, and click Reset Jessica. Now this goes back to my original layout the way I had it. Another thing you should know is that with the workspace, Adobe has created a bunch of workspaces for you that are related to specific tasks. So if you know that you're going to create a tracing document, you drew something, scanned it, and you want to trace it and turn it into a vector digital art object, then you might want to choose the tracing workspace, and it'll bring up a bunch of different panels that relate to image trace. The panel that you should start out with anytime you open Adobe Illustrator for the very first time would be Essentials. So I can click Essentials, and as you can see, it kind of brings up all this other stuff. So I can go to Workspace and reset that Essentials, and this is how Adobe Illustrator starts out the first time you ever open up that program. One more thing, if you have a couple of different documents open, let's say I create a new one, and let's do just two artboards for this one. If you have two different documents open, just know that you can go to this Arrange button to see them side by side, simultaneously, to see them one on top of the other, and this is a good way to move artwork between projects. Or you can go back to consolidating them all, and this is where you can see your two various documents. You can also get to that Arrange here.